but I'm going. Just hope there's a latch.
I'm aware of it. It's a latch.
Down, just hit the latch. Yep. Oh my God, I love you. I love you.
Can you come over? I'm gonna
come with you. Do the best I can for work.
Oh. No, let's go to the main entrance, bro. Let's go to the main entrance. That'll be fine.
Hey, I just went a text. Soon.
Just
look, stop stressing this guy. This
Christmas
is really
his mind.
Yes, he's gonna respond. He sees us, but he's not.
He's gonna see us. Right.
You guys went to the main entrance, didn't you?
No.
Yeah.
No,
you're here.
No. Mm-hmm.
I bet you stopped at Chick-fil-A on the way, didn't you? It didn't bring me anything. You can smell it on the floor. I hope it's not from you.
What are you doing?
It's okay. It's okay. I'm on your side. I'm on your side.
Hi, everyone. How are we doing today? We all right? Fantastic. Wonderful. So glad that you could join us today for today's production of Charles Dickens' immortal classic, Please Do Not Stand on the Stage. why are you still smiling? That's not good.
Switch it!
Thank you. Yeah, we're gonna try this one more time. So glad that you could join us for today's production of Charles Dickens' immortal classic, A Christmas Carol.
Thank you.
Take it away. Take it away. Get off the thing.
Tajon,
where's the clock?
I'm sorry, can you bring out the clock when the clock
dance? What clock? The clock.
What clock?
This show doesn't happen without a clock. So we don't have a clock? Sorry, you guys, the show's not happening, guys. Oh, just kidding. It's fine. So, since we don't have a clock, because Thor forgot it, I just need you guys to be the clock, all right? So, anytime someone on the stage says, Gong Squad, I just need you guys to respond by saying, Gong. All right, let's practice. Gong Squad.
Gong.
Gong Squad.
Gong.
You can give me a little more, but it's fine. I'll take what I'm giving. All right, that's perfectly fine. All right, so I'm pretty sure you guys have noticed that there is a gong over here. All right, does anyone over here want to be the gong master? You want to be the gong master? All right, so wait, where's the mallet? Or is there a mallet in there?
A mallet?
The mallet. The mallet.
What are you talking about?
The mallet.
The mallet.
Is that what this is?
Whatever. I don't know what this is, Thor. This is.
I don't know what that is.
It's a boxing glove on a stick. Where did you find this? You know what? We're gonna roll with it. All right. This is a mallet. All right. It has been sanitized. All right. You're welcome. There you go. All right. So anytime someone says "Gong Squad," you just hit this as hard as you can. All right. Gong Squad.
Gong
Squad. Oh, that's a good one. You almost, the gong is up here, not back there, alright? You're doing great, alright? I don't want to alarm you, but the success of this show rests in your hands. No pressure! Oh my goodness, alright. You're gonna do great, y'all are gonna do great, we're gonna do the best that we can, alright? And if it's not good, then I apologize that all of you hate to be here, okay? Cool. So, Stone Mountain Park is proud to present Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol! Gong Squad!
Marley was dead to begin with.
Yes, there was no doubt whatsoever about.
The register of his burial was signed by the clergyman.
The clerk.
And the undertaker.
Yes,
there is no doubt.
Marley was dead as a doom.
Must be distinctly understood, or nothing wonderful can come of the tale we are about to relate, that of one Ebenezer Scrooge, old Marley's partner in business.
Yes, Scrooge kept the business running, and he, like his old business partner Marley, was a typhus man at the grindstone.
Scrooge!
A squeezing!
Scraping!
Scratching!
Gasping!
Clutching!
Hey, I think they get it. Thank you.
Covetous old sinner! Come on!
Once upon a time, on all the good days of the year, Christmas Eve, Scrooge that business office turned his money.
A 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28.
Mr. Scrooge, sir.
Blast!
Well, Cricket,
Ratchet. I don't care. What is it? You pest, I've lost count.
Well, if it's not too much trouble, I was
6 feet. Is that 6 feet? 6 feet. What do you want?
Well, if it's not too much trouble, I was
if you would be so kind. Open it! We don't have much time. I need another piece of coal for the fire.
Why?
Mine's gone out and my desk is covered with frost.
Frost?
Why is that a problem? You were just saying the other day, oh, I'm so happy that George is getting colder. I love Christmas.
Yes, but I didn't think I'd have to contend with it inside the office.
Oh, you have complaints, do you? Okay, so you're gonna cross over here.
Right here.
Cross.
Since when?
This is since the last rehearsal that we had.
Wasn't that the last rehearsal?
You were another, okay. That was the day that you had your therapy appointment.
Yeah.
Do you feel better about yourself? Okay. All right, well. We'll talk about that later. We'll unpack it after the show. All right, now, Bob Creakle.
Cratchit.
Tell me, how many pieces of coal did you use yesterday?
Just the one.
And how many the day before that?
One.
And the day before that?
One.
So, why would I be inclined to give you an extra piece of coal today, when one was enough yesterday, and one the day before that? And don't even say, oh, but Mr. Scrooge, it's Christmas time, and I'm cold, and my family depends on me having adequate working conditions, which you're not entitled to. Check OSHA's website.
Is that OSHA?
That is OSHA, I think. Is that OSHA? I don't know. Whatever. And I suppose you want tomorrow off too, don't you?
Sir, it's almost
Christmas! Which was, this was like, we workshopped this like 2 months ago. It's fine. All right.
It says you wrote puppy.
Puppy. No. Puppy dog eyes. Give me puppy dog eyes. Which makes more sense. Does it make more sense? That's better. I'll take it. That's fine. All right. Ah! Take the day off tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
But you must be in early the day after.
Of course.
Hey. That was like really, really good.
Yeah, I know I'm good.
Yep. Oh. Okay. Well, someone is a little full of themselves, but it's fine. Gong Squad!
At length, the hour for shutting up the counting house arrived, and Scrooge stepped out into the dreary streets.
He took his usual melancholy meal.
It's salty.
At his usual melancholy tavern.
It's gold.
And after reading the important news of the day...
Oh, lovely! We're getting 2,000... Oh, no, we're not. Sorry.
Okay. He went home.
Yes, and what a home it was, you see. Spruce lived in quarters that previously belonged to his deceased business partner, Marley. They were dark, gloomy, and cold. But they fit the miser like a glove, but on this night, something seemed amiss.
Something seemed amiss. Where's my blanket?
Shortly after climbing in bed, Scrooge heard something strange.
That must have been the wind. Go over that. It's strange for the wind to know my name, but it's fine. They don't know my full name. They didn't say my first name. I'm just gonna pretend like I'm not home and they'll go away on their own. That's how soliciting works. It's a latch down at the bottom.
It's body
it's
back.
No, it's not. Just lift up and push.
Scrooge.
Lift
just,
and push.
I can't.
Jacob Marley! Oh. What is going on with all the fog?
I think it broke the fog machine.
You broke the fog? That's a rental! Yeah. Like what? Fantastic. Where's the Marley costume?
I left it in my car.
And are those real chains?
Yeah, I found them backstage for a second too.
Wonderful. Oh.
They are the chains I forged in life! I made them link by link and yard by yard. Is their pattern strange to you, Ebenezer?
Why are you talking like that?
Because I am warning you! You have forged your own chains and have had more time to do so.
Jacob Marley, I don't have chains.
They are metaphorical chains, but believe me, they bind.
Marley, do you suffer?
More than you could know.
This guy. You don't have to go full Meryl Streep on us.
You will be visited by three spirits. The first will appear tonight at the stroke of midnight. The second tomorrow night at the stroke of midnight. And the third...
The day after tomorrow's
stroke
of midnight. Okay, sorry.
Just be home by midnight, Ebenezer. I must depart, but heed my warning, for in these spirits lies your salvation. Vation. Vation. Vation.
Just go.
Well, how am I supposed to sleep now?
Next one!
Sorry, we already have a gong. Thank you.
Tossed and turned. He was exhausted. He felt almost beaten by struggles.
Was it the conversation with the spirit?
Oh, okay.
It was in every place.
All right, what is that?
Trouble.
It's
suddenly attacking me. Okay, you guys love this scene too much.
It's a tremendous stress.
Let me look.
Finally, after hours of tossing and turning, Scrooge finally settled into a deep sleep, and then...
Dump squat!
Yeah!
You didn't give me a pillow!
Midnight? But it was 3 a.m. before I went to bed. How is this possible? How is this possible?
It's the latch at the bottom.
I know it's a latch for
the
It's jammed.
It's
no,
it's not jammed. It's
pulled off. You have to push. I believe in you. I believe
in you. It's not right? Locked.
Open the door!
Let's just get out there!
And the ghost of Christmas! There's no way you would know this, Bobby, but I got a haircut. Does it look good?
Like, it looks, yeah. It's like a totally Tracy Turnblad.
I mean, it has no punch draw in it.
Right?
You! Down there!
Me?
Yes, you! Are you ready to go on a journey to the past?
Why are we journeying into the past?
To visit you, my dear boy.
Oh, okay.
Step through this window, walk with a stranger. But be careful, Scrooge. Things are about to get real.
Is that me?
I am young Ebenezer Scrooge. I am currently attending a prestigious private university, which is merely the first step on my journey towards predestined greatness. Who knows how high I will climb? Will I be the mayor? Will I be a millionaire? Will I do classic Christmas stories with my two best friends?
Best friends? We just met you.
I'm just getting some extra work done before the holidays. But for now, I'm just waiting. I'm just waiting.
Hurry up.
And waiting. And just waiting. Isabel!
Oh, I'm coming!
Isabel!
I'm coming from the airport, sorry!
Isabel,
my one true love! I haven't seen her in decades!
Isabel, you're... late.
Well, I have to find the shower that you got me for quizzing.
This is very inconsiderate, Isabel. You know how busy I am.
The man is little to you, does it not? Another idol has replaced me, and if he can make you happy, Scrooge, then I have no reason to grieve.
Another idol? What are you talking about?
A golden one?
What? You mean money?
Yes, money! And in pursuit of your money, I've watched all your nobler aspirations follow one by one.
Money is the way the world works, Isabel. Nothing in this life is harder than poverty, and I seek to avoid that. I work day in and day out to make sure that one day we will want for nothing. This is a new era, Isabel. Only the strong will survive. I must never take my eye off the ball. They'll say, no one works harder than Ebenezer. And one day, success will be synonymous with the name Scrooge. I want a better life, Isabel, for both of Isabel? Isabel? Isabel! Chin up, old boy. You have business to attend to.
Isabel, my one true love, gone forever! I love her even now!
Wonderful. But we mustn't dawdle on that for too long. We have to get you back to bed, my dear boy. Now, take this. It'll keep you warm as you continue on your journey.
Continue?
Oh, yes.
What do you mean?
You still have two more spears to get through, Sugar Plum. Now, farewell.
No!
Don't. Just leave.
Isabel, money, two spirits. Two spirits walk into a bar and the bartender says, why the long fade? That usually gets a bigger laugh.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does. It's midnight again! Midnight again! Yes. Come in.
Scrooge?
Yes.
Ebenezer Scrooge.
Yes, that's me.
You would not believe how many houses I've been to before this one. I've encountered on the Cole Scrooge, a Daniel Scrooge, not an Ebenezer until now.
Well, you should probably find a new GPS.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Do you? So you're Scrooge. You ready to go on a journey or whatever, my dear boy?
Where are we going?
Tonight we are looking upon a feast that is both humble in size, but also mighty bountiful in spirit.
Well, is it far away?
Not at all. Just grab onto my robe and we'll be on the way.
Grab your robe?
Grab the robe.
That's not in the script. Did you sanitize it?
I'm sure you did. I'm sure.
Okay, fine. Whatever.
Now, Alexa, play my travel jams.
Okay. Now playing Seat Shake and Travel Jams.
Why did you add this? Like, I'm way over. No, that's not okay. You have to ask before you can think.
Oh, it's on Spotify. I just hit shuffle and it came up. That's why I'm supposed to not add songs I like.
Well, I do like this song too.
Right?
Welcome back, Senora. Welcome
to the
time. There you go.
Home again. Come in the line.
Work your body in time. Okay.
Home again.
Oh, that's my clerk. Well, Carmichael. I was close. Carmichael Cratchit. Same thing.
Yay, home again!
Oh, Tiny Tim!
Dad!
Tiny...
Dad! Dad! Dad!
What are you doing?
What?
You have the beard on. The leg. You still have the beard.
The leg.
Ow, my leg hurts.
Oh, hello, my son!
Hey, Dad. Was I a good boy in church today?
Oh, yes, you were as good as gold. Even better.
Good. 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 Dad! Dad!
Yes, my son?
What's for dinner? I'm starving.
I don't know. Let me go talk to your mother.
Okay. But Dad!
Yes, I'm right here, son. What do you need?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you too, my dear boy. Oh, hello, darling.
Oh, hello, Bob.
How are you doing today?
I'm okay. How are you?
I'm doing all right. Say, would you mind watching Tiny Tim for a while I get the frost out of my hair?
I don't mind at all. I'll go out in just a few more seconds. Just give me 10 more seconds and I'll go out there, Bob. All right, I'm going now. Okay. Hello, my son, and I don't suppose you... I don't suppose you know if that handsome devil father of yours remembered to pick up bread at the market this evening.
No.
Mommy.
Mommy, he didn't forget.
Oh, good.
There was no need to go to the market after Father gave all our money away.
What?
Well, yes, we were coming home from church and we were a beggar. I said, Father, it'd be mad charitable if you gave that beggar some of our money.
He's so sweet, isn't he, folks? And I suppose your... And I suppose your father said something like, well, unfortunately, my tyrant of a boss, Ebenezer Scrooge, barely pays me a little wage, so I need to take home every cent I make so that my wife can put food on the table. Did he say that?
No, none of that sounds familiar. Mm-hmm. But he must have been feeling especially charitable because he gave the beggar all of our money. Isn't that nice of him?
All of it?
Your father won't be happy until we're sleeping in the gutter, will he? I'm going to go have a word with that father of yours right now.
But do you mind having that word out here so I can see both of you at the same time this hour?
I don't think that would be good because we're
definitely different people, so we're going to talk backstage, back in the other room, yes. Okay. Bob Cratchit! I cannot believe you gave away all of our money! Oh, darling, please calm down. I will not calm down! You get up there right now and you tell Ellison that all we can afford to eat tonight is beans!
Oh, hello, son. I just finished speaking with your lovely mother, and she says that we're having beans for dinner.
I love beans! Oh! God bless us! Thank you! Thank you! She read the book!
Yes! A round of applause for this woman right here! Yes! Yes! Wonderful! Did you cheat? Did you know someone in the show? Did you? No? Okay, fantastic. It's fine. I think you're lying. But, you know, it's fine. Oh, Spirit! Such a wonderful family! Wonderful, lovely child. I hope he lives a long and fruitful and happy life.
Well, you would think and you would hope, right?
Oh, yes, 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 I do, yes.
Too bad he's not going to.
What?
Very
Spirit,
bad.
What do you mean?
Oh, well, I foresee a vacancy at the table and a broken crutch without an owner.
He was the one that broke it. We all saw that.
Oh, well, he was excited about those beans. What
yes, he was aggressively excited about those beans. I don't know why. Oh, Spirit, say it's not so. Say he will live.
I cannot say that. But I'll tell you one thing I can say.
Yes?
It is all your fault.
It's my fault?
My fault.
Yes, it is.
No, but we mustn't spend too much time on that. Go, go, go. Let's get you back to this bed.
Scrooge. Okay.
All right. Now, here. Take this. You have one more spirit visitor to get through. Just yes. Keep in mind everything you've seen here.
Are you going to tuck me in?
Kind of.
Yeah.
Things are about to get. Become a better person, Scrooge!
Okay.
This is on you!
You put the blanket on the wrong end of it!
Oh, Dad! If I could turn back time, if I could find a way, I'd go back and save Tiny Tim.
Shit, get out of my dream!
It's midnight again!
Alright, where's that third spirit? I'm ready for him. Has anyone seen a spirit? Can you do me a favor? When the spirit comes out, let me know where he is. Because I'm ready. This one. Okay, now, I would expect that from a child. Alright, this way? Alright, so you see. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on you again. Alright, you got one more time. Don't look. I don't want to hear from you again. Anyone else? This way? Behind me? Okay. Alright, so this is like what? Like, play with the old people there? Like, what is it? Right. Do you hate me? Alright? Am I not giving you good enough support? Can you give me a second, please? Because I'm like talking to all. Sneak up on me! Please! Goodness! Are you the third spirit? You're not? Okay, alright. And you're the ghost of Christmas yet to come? So no words? None. And you're here to show me the future? You can respond. Before you respond? Okay, alright. Oh, that's fine. Well, let's get on with it. I'm trying to make it to Walmart before they run out of toilet paper again. So. Where are you taking me, Spirit? Take me home! Take me home! Oh, that's my clerk, Bob Cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
That was
even closer than Carmichael, okay? Right.
Well, I've got a pop of sunshine. I've got a lot of no doubts. Oh my no. Whoa. Take me away. A secret place. A secret place. Take me away.
Do you mind? You made
what?
The note this time. You
got it. Do you mind? I'm in the middle of working here. Take me away. A secret place. A secret. You're lucky I'm tired. I've been working 4-8 hours.
What's going on over there? What's this little party? Tears. Oh, this was your boy. Oh, sorry about that, man. You must have been a good one, huh?
He was a very good boy.
Yeah, yeah, they all say that around here. How old would you say
he was? He just turned 8.
Just turned 8? Are you ready for a coincidence, bud? I've got me an 8-year-old.
Oh, really?
Yeah, back at home. Hard to get them to sit down in one place, right? I'm like, hey, you sit down, do your homework. And they're like, no, just want to run legal lasers.
Well, I suppose you want to be paid then.
Oh, absolutely.
Merry Christmas.
Sir, I'm so sorry. I don't know if you read this before you handed it over, but it says $1. Like $1 says right there?
That's the flat rate, yes?
Yes, it is the flat rate. I remember that. But, is there any room for Christmas? Bonus of sorts, I don't know what they call these days.
You want a tip?
A tip? I would love a tip if you could just put
that on top of it. Of course, of course. I guess I just won't eat this week.
Alright, that's awful sad what you said right there. Here's what I can do. What's your favorite holiday meal?
Turkey.
That's alright. I can take this Christmas tip. I think they have some turkey down in the marketplace.
Just right down there.
No way! I live right down there, the big blue one. That's me!
Oh, really?
Yeah! So you live around
there? Yeah. About this turkey.
Yeah. I'm gonna take the tip that you gave me, go get the marketplace with the biggest turkey I can find, and then I'll walk all the way down there to your house, and I'm gonna find it. I'm gonna look at it. I'm gonna be like, man, thank you for the thank you for the suggestion for the turkey. And then I'm gonna turn around and walk into my house and put on the table and feed you the turkey. Is that good with you? Yes, that's good with me, Mr. Great Kicker. Oh, that one said basically. Joy to you, the world, and some other lyrics.
Christmas. Humbug.
No.
No. Bob, come back. Spirit, that's not okay. Come out here and face your crime. Oh, come on. Stop sneaking up on me. Trying to mourn for this poor child. What could be a worse fate for anybody? What is this? Spirit, what are you showing me? What? Here lies Ebenezer Scrooge. No! Spirit, not I! Tell me, did anyone come to my funeral?
Down squad.
Fantastic. Oh, thank you, Gong Squad. You all are my true friends. Spirit, tell me, are these shades of what will be, or merely shades of what may be? Before you answer, remember, you can use your words. Fantastic. No way. Wonderful. The Spirit! Hear me! I am a changed man! Why show me all of this if I am beyond all hope? Not this again! Spirit! 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 Tell me hope! Excuse me, where's my little thing? Thank you. Thank you again. Spirit! Take me home! Take me home! Skunk Squad! Why, it's morning! It's morning and I'm home! I might not have missed it! I might not be too late! You there! Boy! What day is it?
Christmas.
Christmas? Wonderful! I haven't missed it. Here, take... I'll wait. Okay, here. Take this money and go down to the marketplace. Alright? You get the biggest turkey that you can find.
Alright.
Alright? Deliver it to this. I'll text it to you. Alright? I'm not gonna write on you. I'll text the address to you. Deliver it to that address. That's the home of Bob Cratchit. Cratchit? I pissed up his name again. Cratchit. And I wish he and his tiny child and his wonderful wife a Merry Christmas. And whatever change is left is yours. Now go.
Oh, thanks, man. Merry Christmas.
Of course. Merry Christmas. Happy to see that you can look up from your phone for a split second. And I promise I will keep Christmas well now and on.
And Scrooge was better than his word. He did, and infinitely more. And for Tiny Tim, who did not die, Scrooge was as loving and kind as if he were part of the family.
He became as good a friend, as good an employer, and as good a soul as the city ever knew. He had no further discourse with spirits, and everyone said for the rest of his days that he knew how to keep the spirit of Christmas alive and well. May that truly be said of all of us. And so, as Tiny Tim observed,
God bless us.
Everyone! Thank you all so much for coming to our performance of A Christmas Carol. We hope you have had a very Merry Christmas, an incredibly happy holiday season, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your day here at Stone Mountain Park. Thank you all so much. One more time, Gong Squad! We'll see you all again.
Thank you, Vicky. We'd like to take this opportunity to remind you to turn your cell phones and other electronic devices to silent operation and to refrain from smoking in all Stone Mountain Park buildings and venues so as not to disturb the enjoyment of others. Flash photography is prohibited during the performance for the safety of the performers. Please note the emergency exits at the rear of the house and the emergency exit backstage. Thank you for joining us for A Stone Mountain Christmas. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy this performance of The Littlest Christmas Tree.
what are you doing here?
What do you mean?
Why are you here alone? Are you a Christmas tree?
No, I'm just a regular tree.
But all the other trees have gone to people's homes to be decorated with tinsel and wood.
And beautiful twinkling lights.
And a beautiful star on top.
Oh. Well, for now it's just me, all by myself.
Well, you didn't want to go home with a family?
Well, I did, but no one chose me.
Nobody?
Oh. I'm sorry.
It's okay. There's always next year.
Well, maybe it's because you're so small.
Nutty, that's not helping. Oh,
sorry, but she is kind of tiny. You're short, I mean. You know, like a little lady, because, you know, there's not much there.
Nutty, put a sock in it.
Oh, my, I think I said too much.
You think? Oh, he's right, it's true. And probably too little to be a Christmas tree.
Hey, that little tree, I know what it's like to be lonely. When you're a skunk, folks don't like to be around
that's a very good point.
And yeah, it's because I hold my breath a lot.
It sure does help if you stay down.
And he's our buddy.
Oh, yeah, that too.
I'll be your friend.
We're best friends.
Good buddies.
Dear old chums.
Yeah, but I don't have anything better to do. Or no one can have too many friends.
That's better, you nut job.
But you don't even know me.
Well, then we'll get to know you.
I love trees. I'm climbing in them all the time.
It's trouble, just get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Sing hallelujah, come on, get happy. Heaven for Christmas Day.
Jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Jingle bells, jingle bells.
jingle bells, jingle all the way.
Thank you. Dancing, prancing, remixing on Comet, Cupid, Donna, and listen to the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away, all!
All you need is the belief in miracles.
The magic boy needs to have peace and joy.
littlest Christmas tree there ever was.
For a Stone Mountain Christmas, and enjoy the show.
Yay.
Welcome to Stone Mountain's Christmas in the City, taking you to the finest holiday destinations in the USA. From the simple lights of Broadway to the merry Latin beat of Miami, from LA to Nashville and Motown to our hometown, we're going places. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the journey, because we're on our way to Christmas in the City.
Christmas in the city.
Driving in on US 1, traveling along the beach on Brickell Avenue, through Coconut Grove into the heart of Little Havana. The temperatures are hot, and so is the music. You may not find chestnuts roasting on an open fire, but you will find people in the club enjoying the contagious Latin beats. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Miami! because we're heading north to the Motor City, Detroit. Anyone from Michigan will tell you to visit Wild Lights at the Zoo or Broder's Christmas Store with 6,000 types of Christmas ornaments, 400 styles of nativity scenes, and miles of Christmas lights and trees. But what we really love about Detroit is the music that was born here. Those soothing sounds originating from gospel music and then mixing with soul. These are the sounds of Motown.
Right outside my door. Someday at Christmas we'll see a man. No hungry children, no empty hand. One happy morning he won't share. What a world where people care.
Someday at Christmas there'll be no tears. A merry boy will make his fears. One shining
south to the Music City of America, Nashville. Put on your Christmas cowboy boots and shuffle on over to the heart of country music. Every street corner is filled with the joyous sounds of holiday music from the past, the present, and if you listen real close, to the music of the future.
With all the family.
chicken pie with buns and ham, and one with butter on the bread. But the best thing about Grandma's house was a great big feather bed.
It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, and slept in a dining chair. It was made from the best of all the enemies to hold that lot on the table. It could hold 8 kids and 4 pound ones, and the babies stole from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
Some we'd sit around the fire, the old folks spin and chew. Pa would talk about the farm and the war, and Granny'd sing about it too. And I'd sit and listen and I'd watch the fire till the pot would spin in my head. Next thing I knew, I'd wake up in the morning in the middle of the feather bed.
It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, and soft as a downy chick. It was made for the best of all the young geese, and for all what a lot would take.
As we can go. We won't find snow-covered trees and below-zero temperatures, but there is a Christmas spirit that is full of flash and sparkle, and it sits in the shadow of the Hollywood sign. Music fills the night from Pasadena to Beverly Hills, from the Valley to Century City. As the home of pop music, the City of Angels pulls the stars from the sky and places them on Earth. Welcome to Los Angeles.
The fireplace is burning bright, shining all on me. I see the presents under me, the good old Christmas tree. And I wait all night till Santa comes to wake me from my sleep. Oh, why? 'Cause that's Christmas to me. I've got this Christmas song.
Was cold and gray.
would rather be this season than right here with all of you. The glow of the fire and the twinkling lights on the tree is like a blanket of love that keeps our hearts warm. No matter where we travel, no matter where we run, we will always find ourselves right back here to celebrate Christmas in this amazing city with all of you. So we welcome you home to Atlanta!
Came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, Snowman was a jolly, happy soul, with a corncob pipe and a button nose, and two eyes made out of coal. Frosty the Snowman made the children smile, they say, and were they surprised when he rolled his eyes and he came to life that day. There must have been some magic in that old silk hat they found, for when they placed it on his head, he began to dance around. Frosty the Snowman was a lad as he could be, and the children say he could laugh and play just the same as you and me. Down to the village, with a broomstick in his hand, running here and there and around the square, saying, catch me if you can. He led them down the streets of town, right to the traffic cop, and he only paused a moment when he heard him holler, stop. Frosty the Snowman had a hurry on his way, but he waved goodbye, saying, don't you cry, I'll be back again someday. Tumpity tump tump, tumpity tump tump, look at Frosty go. Tumpity tump tump, tumpity tump tump, over the hills and snow.
No one.